This Tuit skill is on SmartBoard tools and focuses on the Spotlight tool. Spotlight allows you to highlight any particular area on the screen in any program. So let's see how you can use this. I have Finder open right now, and on the left side I have my SmartBoard tools. I'll open it using the double arrow, and I see the Spotlight tool, and all I need to do is click on it. And what it does is it blacks out everything except for the spotlight that's open. This is an active area of the screen. If I want to move the spotlight, all I need to do is click anywhere on the black and move my finger, and it will also move the spotlight. So it does not matter where in the black I choose to move, it will move the spotlight correspondingly. If I want to change the size of the spotlight, all I need to do is choose the blue section, and I can change the aspect ratio of it, either making it a tall ellipse or a wide ellipse or a nice circle, a small one or a large one. And then I can again move that into any particular area. If I choose the drop-down menu on the spotlight, I can change the transparency to a variety of different percentages. I'm going to choose 50%, which will allow me to see the rest of the screen and still allow me to focus attention on that one or two particular areas that I want to draw attention to. So there's a variety of ways I can change that. I can also choose the drop down again and go to shape, and right now it's on ellipse. I'm going to choose rectangle, and on the rectangle it changes it either to a square or a rectangle size, and again I'm going to choose the blue border on it, and I can either go to a long rectangle or a square or what have you. Now this is good if I am using any text, or I want to highlight a text box or a web address or something. Any time is good for using that if I have a text box. Third one in here in shape is the star. The star gives you basically a star. I don't find that as effective as the ellipse and the rectangle, but it's still there as a choice. I'm going to drop down and go to quit, which is the third option, and that takes away the Spotlight tool. Now this Spotlight tool runs on top of any other program that you're running. Notebook also has a Spotlight tool in the Magic Pen, and I want to compare the differences between the two. So I'm going to open up Notebook, and I'm going to pick up the pen and choose Magic Pen on the toolbar. And to make a spotlight, I'm just going to draw a circle, and it will make a spotlight. I'll put my pen down, and in this spotlight, I can move any other place by choosing the black area. Notice that it is not black. It is a dark shade of gray. Also, you can change the size of it, not by clicking on the blue border on it, but by going directly in the middle, either to the side or up and down. And again, you can close this one by clicking the red dot on there, and it will close it. The one in Magic Pen only allows you to do the spotlight within that one page of Notebook. So it allows you to go into there. The Spotlight tool in the SmartBoard tools allows you to do the spotlight in any program. So if I choose the spotlight again, I'm going to move it in any section. The other thing about the SmartBoard Spotlight is I can control anything. So I can go into pictures and backgrounds. Anything that I touch on the inside of the spotlight is actually activated. So I'm going to quit that again, and we'll be able to see everything that's in here. So that's how you can use the spotlight in SmartBoard tools. Now it's time for you to get to it.